This is just like the biggest misconception about
that is
you.
The biggest misconception that I'm on drugs, yeah, and it's in America, but in Paris I'm a 10. Mm-hmm. So in England I'm a 7. So the way in terms of how I'm perceived according to who I am.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, I don't like having middle America go -1 on my ass, because you know that behind the music really did help. You know, I mean, I think the second hour is a waste. I think you could have talked about fashion, you could have talked about films, you could have talked about the fact that we've been nominated for 11 Grammys, you could have talked about the fact that we've sold like 9.5 million records, so a little more than that worldwide. You could have talked about, you could have talked about the finances, you could, you know, I mean, it's like Guns N' Roses have made $2.2 billion and Nirvana sold more than Guns N' Roses. Where's my daughter's money? Hi.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Why do I have a debit card? So on and so forth. And, you know, instead they sort of just namby-pambied it and made it into this sort of Valentine about live through this and Kurt, which is fine for the first hour. You're crying on the first hour if you watch it, but the second hour is just a waste. And, you know, I gave 45 pages of notes. They didn't have to interview anyone extra, just what to cut, what not to cut, what pictures to use, what made sense, yada yada. Nobody did anything. Hmm. And, you know, basically if you don't do it yourself, it's not going to happen. So spiritually, we were talking about, I was 21. I was walking down Melrose Avenue in L.A. Somebody said, do you want a chant? And I said, sure, I'll fucking try anything. I'm game. I want to be enlightened and happy. So I went and I chanted, and this woman was really doing well. She was directing videos. And the more people's houses, I lived on the street. And had my little $500 a month that would go like that. And I begged sometimes. I stripped sometimes. I worked on movies. And my first boyfriend's mom, who was no longer my boyfriend, would keep my checks. He's my only living boyfriend that won't talk to me. But that shit. Jeff Mann won't talk to me.